Hello children, my name is Mrs. B and today I'll be reading to you The Secret Sky Garden by Linda Zahra and Fiona Lumbers. Funny like the old airport car park, it hadn't been used for years and was greyer than a Monday sky. But Funny loved being there, hearing the planes take off and touch down, while the blue rooftop stretched for miles like a calm, still sea. She came there more Saturdays, sometimes with a Kestrel Warrior stunt kite, sometimes with a recorder. But something was missing, definitely. She'd learned to play the sounds around notes from the tunnel in the terminal, the high, low whine of planes coming into land, and the music of bells in City Square. But something was missing, definitely. So she hatched a plan. Each Saturday, Funny lugged up a huge sack of soil, cleaned the carpet of litter, swept the drift of squished cans and other left behinds. After 3 months of Saturdays, she gently nuzzled seeds into the soil that now completely covered the rooftop car park. It was Zoo who first noticed, coming into land on his flight home from Dad's. "Wow," he grinned bigger than in 3 months. "I've got to go there," he thought. A garden there in the air, full of flowers, bright like an emperor's blanket, nodding and waving hello. Funny watered her flowers, flew her fierce kite, played a new song she'd learnt from a tiny red radio found in a stairwell. But something was missing, definitely. That feeling, like an ache, a hole, not a full-up satisfied feeling you get when you're happy, and there's the warm buzz of home and someone laughing in another room. And that's when Zoo arrived. Grinning shyly, he told her how amazing her car park garden looked from way up there. "It's awesome. I saw it and thought I must be dreaming." And it turns out they both flew kites. Zoo's was shaped like a shield. He also played a silver harmonica and could soon play all the sounds around. The notes of the tannoy, the descending hum, the chiming bells. And as the sky darkens when you're coming into land, you might notice some bright sparks. Maybe fairy lights, maybe fireworks. And if you come closer, you might hear a whole city of sounds being played by two friends, the kites crisscrossing in the secret sky garden. The end. Thank you for listening.